In part 7 of our lesson on polar equations and graphs, you will learn how to find an equivalent equation for a circle in rectangular coordinates. Let's start off with a little algebra review. You learned how to do a process called completing the square. And if you were given a quadratic in the form of x squared plus bx, you could complete the square by adding a number to that. Now, the way you would find that number is you would take 1/2 of the b, which is the coefficient of x, and then you would take that number and square it. And that would be what you would add in to complete the square. Now, also, a quick reminder of the general equation of a circle. It is in the form x minus h quantity squared plus y minus k quantity squared is equal to r squared, where the center of the circle is h comma k, and the radius of the circle is r, which would be the square root of r squared. So let's see how we can use this to help us in our graphing. In this example, we have to find an equivalent equation in rectangular coordinates and sketch a graph of r equals 6 sine of theta. Now, we wish that this was an r sine theta in there, because then we could use the conversion factor where r sine of theta is equal to y. Remember that this is an equation, so we are allowed to do the same thing to both sides. So let's take this equation and multiply both sides by r. Then our equation will become r squared is equal to 6 r sine theta. Now we will be able to do a substitution here where r sine theta will get replaced with y. So the right hand side will become 6 times y. Now on the left hand side, we know that the conversion factor is that r is equal to the square root of x squared plus y squared. So then it follows that r squared is going to get replaced with x squared plus y squared. So we can bring that in on the left hand side. So now our equation is x squared plus y squared is equal to 6y. Now from your college algebra experience, you may recognize that what you have to do next is get everybody on one side. So we have x squared plus y squared minus 6y is equal to 0. And I'm going to purposely leave some space here and put equals 0 over here. When both the x and y are squared, we recognize that this is going to be the equation of a circle, provided that their coefficients are the same. And both of them have a coefficient of 1, so that means this will be a circle, and we have to get it into that standard equation form of a circle that we just learned, which is x minus h quantity squared plus y minus k quantity squared is equal to r squared. Now, to get this equation to look like this, we will need to complete the square. Now, in the x variable, there's nothing to do because there's no x term. There's only the x squared. So the x squared is going to come straight down. But in the y, we have a y squared and a y term. So that means to complete the square, we will need to take 1/2 of 6 and square that number. 1/2 of 6 is 3, and we know that 3 squared is equal to 9. So what we are going to do is add 9 to the left-hand side, which means we have to add 9 to the right-hand side. And remember that this process that we just did here is called completing the square. So now we know that y squared minus 6y plus 9 is a perfect square trinomial, which can be written y minus 3 quantity squared. The right-hand side is 9. Now this equation is in the form of the general equation for the circle, so we can get that the center of our circle is going to be h, k. Now h is what's in with the x, and there's nothing in with the x, so that means h is 0. K is what's in the subtraction with the y, so that means k is equal to 3. We know that our radius is going to be the square root of the constant on the right-hand side, so we will have to do the square root of 9, which is equal to 3. Now, to graph this equation, we know is very easy. We put the center at 0, 3, and then we go out a radius of 3 in all directions, and we can draw our circle. So once again, what you will want to do is visualize seeing the rectangular coordinate plane being superimposed on your polar graph. We can go to the point 0, 3, and we know that that is our center. And then from the center, we know we are going to go a radius of 3 in all directions. So we can go up by 3, 1, 2, 3, and put a point here. From the center, we can go down by 3, 1, 2, 3, put a point there. Now we also have to go to the right and left by 3. So just again, see that rectangular coordinate plane superimposed on your graph. Now, to start at the center and go to the right by 3, it's probably easiest to come down here and see 1, 2, 3 on your superimposed rectangular coordinate plane. And you know from there you have to go vertically up. From the center, you're going horizontally over. So that means the point would be right here. Same going from the center left by 3. I'm going to come down on the axis, 1, 2, 3 in the negative direction. Make a dotted vertical line. From the center, I'll make a dotted horizontal line. And I know that that means the point is here. And now I connect these four points and I will get my circle. So while we could have graphed in polar coordinates r is equal to 6 sine theta, it would have taken quite a bit of plugging in points and plotting those points. And instead, we were able to convert it to its rectangular equivalent right here. And this rectangular equation we recognize as the general form of a circle, so then it became very quick to plot the center and then go up by 3, down by 3, right by 3, left by 3, and make the graph of our circle. So sometimes it's just easier to convert the polar equation into its equivalent rectangular equation and do the graph from there.